Turn to Hebrews, next person, please. Hebrews 11, 5 and 6.
By faith, Enoch was translated.
Yes.
And was not
what about
found.
That word?
And was not found.
Read it again. Mm-hmm.
By faith, Enoch was translated.
That he should not see what?
Death.
He was what? Translated that he should not see death. Yes.
And was not found. Because God has translated him.
Okay, so the first rapture, God bless you, please. The first rapture is a rapture of Enoch. He did not see death. Rapture is different from resurrection. Resurrection is for those who die and God take them to heaven. Rapture are for those who will not see death, but God takes them to heaven. Enoch was the first person before the destruction of the Noah. It's a rapture.
Takes place.
Before judgment.
One
more time, say rapture.
Rapture.
Takes place. Before judgment of the world.
Before
the Noah's generation to be destroyed, one man walked with God. And God said, you are not going to die with the flood of Noah. I take you alive. He was raptured. Why was he raptured? Is it because he was going to church? Is it because he was a nice man? Enoch had a testimony. Read Hebrews again, please. That Hebrews 11. Left verse. Yeah.
Hebrews 11. Enoch was translated that he should not see death, and was not found because God had translated him.
Yeah.
For
before his rapture, he had what? This testimony. What's the testimony?
That he pleased God.
Amen.
So before he was raptured, before he was translated from earth to glory, from earth to heaven, he had what? A testimony. What was the testimony? He pleased God. Rapture is not for those who call themselves Christians. And for those who please God. Those who personally please God in their personal walk with God. Enoch was like any other person living in the world. And the world was so evil. There was all the hell on earth. But one man decided to make himself different. He had no Bible, no pastor, no church elders. He has no commentaries, no television to watch, preachers. But he pleased God. Hallelujah. And because he pleased God in that time, God saw Enoch. He said, Enoch, you will not go through the flood. He picked him up alive. So hallelujah. So Enoch was the first man raptured. Rapture is very interesting. You know, he was picked up. He was snatched up alive into glory. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
The testimony of Enoch is what I want to emphasize today. Let it be your testimony.
Amen.
Say the name of Jesus.
I
receive the grace
to
please God.
Say
the name of Jesus.
I receive the grace
to please God.
To please God
is a personal decision. It can please the state. It can please your church. It can please your wife. It can please friends. But on judgment day, your wife, your friends, they still will not save you. You need to please God. Say, Enoch. What a testimony. What's the testimony?
Please God.
Amen. Say, please God.
Please God.
Now, that is your challenge. That decision to say, no matter the trials, the temptation, the difficulties, the battles, I will please God. That is the final thing. No matter what you go through, you know, because I've been thinking that, because I was poor, that is why. Because I was single, that is, you don't have any excuse. Amen. Say never. Look at
never.
Please.
Please.
Because I love you. Please God. For the sake of your soul.
For the sake of your soul.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus.
The next festival was Rapture. That is 2 Kings 2, verse 1 to 11, please. Yeah, about that, please. 2 Kings 2, 1 to 11. This is very, very important, please. Here is that, please.
2 Kings 2, verse 1 to 11. And it came to pass, when the Lord was about to take up Elijah into heaven by the wiring, that Elijah went with Elisha from Gilgal. Then Elijah said to Elisha, "Stay here, please, for the Lord has sent me to Bethel." But Elisha said, "As the Lord lives and as your soul lives, I will not leave you." So they went down to Bethel. Now the sons of the prophets who were at Bethel came out to Elisha and said, "Do you know that the Lord will take your master from over you today?" And he answered and said, "Yes, I know. Keep silent." Then Elijah said to him, "Elisha, stay here, please, for the Lord has sent me to Jericho." But he said, "As the Lord lives and as your soul lives, I will not leave you." So they came to Jericho. Now the sons of the prophet who were at Jericho came to Elisha and said to him, "Do you know that the Lord will take your master away from over from you today?" So he answered, "Yes, I know. Keep silent." Then Elijah said to him, "Stay here, please, for the Lord has sent me to Jordan." But he said, "As the Lord lives and as your soul lives, I will not leave you." So the two of them went up. And 50 men of the sons of the prophet went out and stood facing them at a distance while the two of them stood by the Jordan. Now Elijah took his mantle, rolled it up, and struck the water, and it was divided this way and that, so that the two of them crossed over on dry ground. And so it was, when they had crossed over, that Elijah and Elisha asked, Elijah said to Elisha, "Ask, what may I do for you before I am taken away from you?" And Elisha said, "Please let a double portion of your spirit be upon me." So he said, "You have asked a hard thing. Nevertheless, if you see me when I am taken from you, it shall be so for you. But if not, it shall not be so." Then it happened, as they continued on and thought, that suddenly a chariot of fire appeared before
them. Suddenly what?
A chariot of fire.
Continue.
A chariot of fire appeared with horses of fire and separated the two of them. And Elijah went up by the whirlwind into the heaven.
You know whirlwind? Yeah. No, have you seen whirlwind? So, Elijah was a man like you. He was a prophet. I had a lot of Bible schools, school of prophets. He was teaching in Bible school, which is called prophets. All the prophets had a vision that Elijah would be raptured. Are you following us all? They were prophets. They knew that today Elijah will be taken off. They knew. And 500 prophets, they went and stood to see, to watch. You know, and Elijah and Elisha, I don't want to go to the details. As they crossed the Jordan, Elijah and Elisha were together. Suddenly, whirlwind came from heaven, and horses and fire, like lightning, snatched him, picked him up, and Elisha saw him going. The prophet saw him going. He did not die. That's a rapture. The only two men who did not die in the Old Testament was who? Enoch and Elijah. They were raptured. He didn't taste them. We are living in a generation that this rapture will happen soon. But all of these men were men after God's heart. Men who dedicated themselves to please God. Elijah stood against the false prophets. You know, he refused to compromise with the Baal system. He stood against even the king and said, "This cannot happen in Israel." Believers who compromise with the worldly system will not be raptured. Elijah decided to say, "I alone will face 400 false prophets in the land." Hallelujah.
Amen.
And he stood firm. Say, "Nebo."
Nebo.
Are you ready for rapture?
Are you ready for rapture?
You say, "Nebo." Are you ready for rapture?
Are you ready for rapture?
You know, we live in an age where Christianity is becoming socialized, and talk about God. Don't go into personal issues. But that is not the Bible Christianity. Say, Elijah walked with God. And he was what? Raptured. Rapture is in the Bible.
Yes.
The world cannot explain it. The world cannot understand it. This prophet of Baal said, maybe he is falling somewhere in the bush. Let's go and search for him. And they searched for 3 days. They couldn't see Elijah. But today, Elijah is not found. But now, when Christ was about to die, what happened? Moses and Elijah appeared. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And Christ said, God is not a God of the dead. It's a God of the living. Elijah is alive. Moses is what? Alive. And Elijah appeared in glory. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Then you see again, Elijah and Enoch will come again on earth and will die. Yes. No, die. I'm not dead yet. Because no, die. You see that? That'll be the last prophet there. 2 witnesses. You cannot die 2 times. You cannot die and die again. The only 2 persons who did not die will be the one that was sent to preach in tribulation time. And will die. Every human being will test them. They see these ones, if they not die, they're coming back again. But not now. But by then we have gone to heaven.
Amen.
Okay, amen. Hallelujah. Say Enoch was raptured.
Enoch was raptured.
Elijah was raptured.
Elijah was raptured.
Will you be raptured?
Mm-hmm.
Rapture is not high jump. Is that it's okay? Let me try to climb to maybe the tallest bit I do on. And jump! You'll break your bones, please. Don't try that. Rapture is a divine act that God snatches you up.
Mm.
Amen.
Amen.
God picked you up because you walk with Him.
Mm.
It's coming soon. Now, in the Old Testament, are you following me, church? Enoch was raptured in his own world. Say, in his own world.
In his own world.
Enoch was what?
Raptured.
Before the world was destroyed. The world destroyed Enoch with Noah. Mm. So God took Enoch. Elijah came as the prophet in his own, in the Old Testament covenant. And, you know, before they went into Babylonian captivity, you know, the nation of Israel was 70 years, no human being scattered. God picked what? Elijah in his own dispensation. But at this time, it's not going to be one man. It's going to be multitudes of those who are washed by the blood.
Amen.
But before that time, please, let's see the third rapture, please. Matthew 28, verse 6 and 7. Acts 1, verse 9 and 11. The third rapture in the Bible, please. Matthew 28, please, verse 6 and 7.
Matthew 28, verse 6 and 7. He is not here, for he is risen. As he said, come. See the place where the Lord lay. Verse 7. And go quickly and tell his disciples that he is risen from the dead. And behold, he goeth before you into Galilee. There shall ye see him. Lo, I have told you. Amen.
Amen. God bless you. Acts chapter 1, verse 9 to 11.
Acts 1, 9 to 11. And when he had spoken these things,
He spoke these things to the disciples. Amen. Continue.
He was taken up, and a cloud received him out of their sight. And while they looked steadfastly toward heaven as he went up, stood by them in white apparel, which also said, Ye men of Galilee, why stand ye gazing up into heaven? This same Jesus which is taken up from you into heaven shall so come in like manner as ye have seen him go into heaven.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Now, it was not a secret. It didn't happen in the night. It was not, you know, while Christ was talking to about 500 disciples, are you following me, church? Yeah, he preached to them, you know, in Acts chapter 1, verse, I like verse 8 there, about the Holy Ghost, and was still preaching to them, and suddenly, say suddenly.
Suddenly.
What happened? They saw him going. He did not just vanish. Okay. It's a rapture. It's not vanishing.
It's not vanishing.
No. It's what? It's what? Going up in a bodily form. In what?
Body.
It's not a spirit vanishing. So Jesus did not go to heaven as a spirit. He went as what? A person. Amen. So they saw Jesus going up, and they were guessing, watching as he go. And suddenly two angels came, one on the left, one on the right. You men of Galilee, why are you guessing up to heaven? This same Jesus will come back in the same way he went to heaven. So say, Jesus was raptured as a person. Now, this is very, very, very important. Very important. As you see the third rapture, Jesus came to introduce the New Testament, and he says that is how all those who believe in him will be raptured. Faith in Jesus means a lot to me. There is no future without Jesus. Say never.
Never.
Say that. Say never, never, never.
Never, never, never.
There's no future
without Jesus.
You know, let me give you something that will be very difficult for you to understand. Hello. Before I go to the fourth rapture, you know, at this point that hell is not forever. Oh. I said what?
Hell is not forever.
There's something more terrible than hell. Turn to Revelation 20, please. Revelation 20, are you there? Are you sure? I read from verse 11, please. And I saw a great white throne and him that sat on it, from whose face the earth and the heavens fled away, and there was found no place for them. And I saw the dead, small and great, stand before God. And the books were opened, another book was opened, which is the book of life. And the dead were judged out of those things, judged of those things which were written in the books according to their works. Are you there?
Mm-hmm.
13. And the sea gave up the dead which were in it. Those who die in the sea will send them back. Are you following?
Mm-hmm.
Are you there?
Yes.
And that's verse 13, please. And the sea gave up the dead which were in it. And death, say death.
Death.
And what?
Hell.
Delivered of the dead which were in them. And they were judged, every man according to their works. Verse 14. And death, say death.
And hell.
And hell.
Were cast.
Into what?
The lake of fire.
So hell is the detention center. Oh my God. Hellfire is what? The detention center for those who don't have Christ. Waiting for the lake. Have you seen that in the Bible? But that's what I said. What? I've not seen this before like this, you know. So hell is not everlasting. But the lake of what?
Fire.
That is a real struggle. So if the detention center can be traveled like that, then how much for the real prison? Say hell.
Hell.
Say death.
Death.
And hell.
And hell.
Where cast where?
In the lake of fire.
Which bullet will sulfur and brimstone forever and ever. Ever and ever. It's terrible. That is why if you are a Christian and you play with church, you play Christian life and miss the rapture, you've done the worst thing for your life. You've done the worst thing for your life. There is nothing you can replace with your soul.
Mm.
And that is why there is no other option but to hold on Christ. Say never.
Never.
There's no other option.
There's no other option.
Now look at this, please. Hello? Who do you think will solve America's problem? Who there? Is it Trump? Clinton? Bush? No, there's no human being that has answers. The future of the world is in trouble. Yeah. Now, the rapture of the church is the hope of the church, the hope of the church, the hope of the believer. You can mess up your job, but not with your soul. You can mess up with you can mess up with your finances, but not with your soul. Because there's something going to happen very soon. Say very soon. The world will change forever. The meaning is the trumpet of the Lord. And the trumpet will sound. Hallelujah. Say very soon.
Very soon.
Very soon.
Very soon.
We are going home.
We are going home. Karabash.
Hey. Say very soon.
Very soon.
We are going home.
We are going home. Hey.
The world, there's nothing the world can offer anymore.
Nothing.
Listen, before I go to the fourth one, Jesus. Amen. Hello? See, the last thing before judgment of every generation, who know it? Sexuality become legal. Before God destroyed the world of Noah, was what? Because of what?
Homosexuality.
Before God destroyed Sodom and Gomorrah, what happened?
Homosexuality.
Yes, that's it. And this world, in 21st century, they have legalized it. So when you see this now become legalized, where man can, you know, allow, when you see, come on, okay? You know, maybe you don't know this, okay? When you see the real American, see two men, they don't greet, say, good morning, sir. Say, good morning, buddy. You say, what? You know why? I don't know whether you are male or female or wife or husband. You cannot come in good morning, sir. I said, I'm a wife.
I'm a senior.
Oh, so say what? Good morning, buddy. You don't know what's behind because you don't know whether you are wife or you are husband. So the person is what? Buddy. You define your sex. Say the name of Jesus. I'm a child of God. I am washed by the blood.
I'm ready
for the coming of the Lord. Hallelujah. Are you ready? Because the world is corrupt. The only salvation is in Jesus Christ. No politician
can save the world.
The only now that will try is Antichrist that says, I have the answers. They will deceive the world into destruction. Now let's see the fourth rapture. Are you there?
Yes.
1 Thessalonians 4, 13 to 18, and then 1 Corinthians 15, 51 to 53, please. 1 Thessalonians 4, please. 13 through 18. Really carefully, please. It's very, very important.
But I would not have you ignorant. Concerning them which are asleep, that ye sorrow not, even as others which have not hope. For if we believe that Jesus died and rose again, even so them also which sleep in Jesus will God bring with him. For this we say unto you by the word of the Lord, that we which are alive and remain unto the coming of the Lord shall not prevent them which are asleep. Yeah. For the Lord himself shall descend from heaven with a shout, with the voice of the archangel.
Okay, just hold on. For the Lord himself shall do what? Descend from heaven with what? A shout. And with what again? The voice of the archangel. And what? And with the trump of God. Continue, please.
And the dead in Christ shall rise first.
Yes.
Then we which are alive and remain shall be caught up together with them in the cloud to meet the Lord in the air. And so shall we ever be with the Lord.
Hallelujah. Just end there. Say caught up. So that is the Greek word what? We use of rapture. Jesus is saying probably what? Rapture. You don't see the word rapture in the Bible, but what? You have to mean in cut up. Amen. So the Lord himself
shall descend
with the voice of an archangel. And those of us who are alive, who what? The dead will rise. That's resurrection. But those of us who are alive and remain until the coming of the Lord, what happened? You'll be cut off. Now this is the hope of every wise man. If you fail to be caught up, you are not going through the plagues and the suffering in the world. Rapture is the best gift for the church. Amen. You know, rapture, like I see the firefighters, you know, when they break a house and take somebody out and then the flame, boom, the house gets in flame. So before the world goes into the destruction, God says, I'll pick out my children.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. The Lord himself will descend, and the dead in Christ will rise first, and we that are alive and remain, we are not going to see death. We're going to be what?
God. Sure.
Now, this is now a big issue. Because this is now where Christians are tested. Hello? You know, I was in a council meeting some time in Africa, trying to ordain some pastors. Before this, some elders. Before elders ordained, the last person that has been interviewed is their wife. So, ordination was on Sunday morning. Saturday evening, we called the council of those to be ordained and their wives to interview their wives about their husband. We asked one woman, tomorrow, we want to ordain your husband as an elder. What do you say? We thought they would say, praise the Lord, hallelujah. I said, do that man, elder, you don't know him. He's a witch. Okay, everybody was, that with this wicked man, this week, you make this wicked man elder, I'll leave the church. So he's only good in church. As he entered the house, that is you, is it not true? You did not slap yesterday. The pastor like that. Oh. How many Christians are playing drama?
A lot.
Have you looked at them and said, do you play drama?
Do you play drama?
How many Christians are playing what? Playing drama in the name of Christianity.
Don't play drama.
You want to be raptured, please. Be sincere. Be what? It's not acting. We don't act Christianity. We don't act godliness. You want to be raptured, be sincere.
Amen.
Amen. When you say no, stand on it.
Yes.
Hello? For me, I took a stand. I told my children, I made my mind to go to heaven.
Amen.
Amen. In this house, no nonsense. So no nonsense. Say Sally. No what?
Nonsense.
What about you?
No nonsense.
Do you allow smoking in your house?
No. Come on.
You sure? You must draw some lines. Say hello. Say in this house.
No nonsense.
We are going to heaven.
We are going to heaven.
You can do that outside, okay?
Yes.
In this house, what?
No nonsense.
Take a stand. Say what? Take a stand.
Okay,
frown. See, look at them and say, take a stand.
Take a stand.
See a funny face.
Take a stand.
Say, take a stand.
Take a stand.
Say, take a stand. For your spiritual life. Hallelujah. It's time to save your soul. Because there's a lot of comforting messages outside there. You know, one pastor said to his church, God understands. We are all in the struggle.
No, you don't.
God understand we are all in the struggle. You know, God understand your struggle. You know, you are not alone. You know, you are not alone. You are only what? Yeah. So keep on doing the what? The Christ says, stand ye therefore. Say stand.
Stand.
After you do all the word, stand.
Stand.
You must stand. You must be strong by force.
Yes.
See the ball?
Yes.
Fight a battle.
Fight a battle.
Fight the fight of faith.
Stand strong.
Encourage yourself.
Encourage.
Heal your own wounds.
Hey,
say the ball, heal yourself.
Heal yourself.
And you say the ball, heal yourself.
Heal yourself.
It's time to do what? You heal yourself. Nobody wants somebody to say, oh, you do what? You heal yourself. It's serious, eh? Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Somebody said, Bishop Bonnie, preach that church will not grow. That's what somebody told me. Preach that church will not grow. I said, you know, those who know the truth will stay.
Amen.
Those who want, know the truth will stay. Those who want just to go and dance in church. Okay? Then you know the truth will do what? Stay. I think I'm here for people. I came for souls.
Amen.
The souls.
Souls.
Thank God you are here because you know the truth.
Yes. Amen. Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
The truth matters.
Yes. Yes.
Amen. Revelation 11, verse 1 to 12. This is a long reading. It's on this section. Who has the reader, please?
I read. And there was given me a reed like unto a rod. And one said, rise and measure the temple of God and the altar and them that worship therein and the court which is within without the temple.
Just say, for time's sake, okay, okay, start from verse 6, please.
Verse 6.
Let's continue. Yeah. Continue from verse 2. Yeah.
Verse 2. Okay. And the court which is without the temple live without, and measure it not, for it had been given unto the nations, and the holy city shall they tread under foot 40 and 2 months, and I will give unto my 2 witnesses, and they shall prophesy 1,260 days.
How long is that? 3.5 years. Okay. Continue.
Clothed in sackcloth, they are the 2 olive trees and the 2 candlesticks standing before the Lord of the earth. And if any of the 2, and if any man desire to hurt them, fire proceed out of their mouth and devour their enemies. And if any man shall desire to hurt them in this manner, must he be killed. 6. These have the power to shut the heaven, that it rain not during the days of their prophecy. And they have power over the waters to turn them into blood, and to smite the earth with every plague, so often as they shall desire. And when they shall have finished their testimony, the beast that cometh out of the abyss.
Yeah, hold on. So when they are finished their preaching, are you following us? Mm-hmm. Now these are the 2 evangelists in the time of the tribulation. The church is not there, believers are not there. These 2 men will be sent by God with special powers, nothing can kill them. Yeah. And they were preaching for how long? 3.5 years. At the end of their ministry, now read verse 7 again.
Verse 7. The beast that cometh up out of the abyss shall
are you
make.
Verse 7?
Yes, verse 7. And when they shall have finished their testimony, the beast that cometh up out of the abyss shall make war with them and overcome them and kill them.
That's the Antichrist. Continue.
Verse 8. And their dead bodies lie in the street of the great city, which spiritually is called Sodom and Egypt, where also their Lord was crucified.
That is where Jerusalem.
And from among the people and the tribes and the tongues and nations do men look upon their dead bodies 3 days and a half.
So these men, they will lie in the street. People will see them all over the world through satellite, through television, for how long? 3 days. They will lie in death 3 days. Continue.
And suffer not their dead bodies to be laid in a tomb. 10. And they that dwell on the earth rejoice over them and make merry. And they shall send gifts one to another, because these 2 prophets tormented them that dwell on the earth. 11. And after the 3 days and a half, the breath of life from God entered into them, and they stood upon their feet, and the great fear fell upon them that beheld them.
Hallelujah.
Yay.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And verse 12, and they heard a great voice from heaven saying unto them, come up hither. Say, come up hither.
Come up hither.
And they ascended up to where? To heaven in the cloud. And their enemies washed them. Clap your hand, give the Lord glory. Wow.
God, my God.
Hallelujah. How do you call that?
Rapture.
Did it go spiritually?
No,
physically.
So while they were dead, they were lying on the street for 3.5 days. What happened? The breath came into them. And they came back to life. Hallelujah. And God said what? Hey, come up hither. And they got what? They are raptured. And in the sight of the world, on public, in the world, on CNN, CBA, SCB News, all the world channels, they watch them going up to heaven. That's a rapture. That is why, okay, now, amen, let's go to the core of our message now. Amen. Hallelujah. Let me give you five things or four things about rapture. Okay. Amen. You see, that is why I told the Adventist Church, not the Adventist Church. They don't believe, they believe that when a man died, the man is in a stupor theory. Jehovah Witness. You stay in the grave. Ask them, where is Elijah? Where is Enoch? They are not buried. When a man dies, what goes to the grave is what is called what? Body. Not your soul. You don't live in the grave. Amen. Okay. The body is not you. The what goes to the grave is what? The body. The real you is not in the grave.
Yeah.
Amen. Are you following me? So number one, the rapture of the church is the event in which God snatches away unbelievers from the earth in order to do what? To make, are you following me? In order to make way for the righteous judgment to be poured out on the earth during the tribulation. The rapture of the church is the event in which God snatches away the believers of the earth in order to make way for the righteous judgment to be poured out on the earth during the great tribulation. So the rapture is the snatching away of believers before the pouring out of what? Judgment during the great tribulation. The great tribulation is God judging the world. God cannot judge the world with you on earth. So God will take you up and begin to send what? The judgments upon the earth in these last days. It's happening soon. Hallelujah. But before it happens, the church, the born again, those who walk in holiness, those who are serious about their faith, those who have separated themselves unto godliness, will be snatched away. Hallelujah. Thank you. Number two, the rapture will involve an instantaneous transformation of our bodies to fit us for eternity. The rapture will involve an instantaneous transformation of our bodies to fit us for eternity. 1 John 3 verse 2. It says, that's 1 John 3 verse 2. It says, when we know that when he, Christ, appears, we shall be like him, for we shall see him as he is. Amen. So the rapture involves this instantaneous transformation. Your body is changed to a spiritual dimension, to a celestial body, so we prepare us for what? Eternity. You're not going to have a flesh and blood. You're going to be what? A miraculous, instantaneous change in your body. Number three, the rapture is to be distinguished from the second coming of Christ. At the rapture, the Lord comes in a cloud and meets us in the air. Are you following us all? At the second coming of Christ, the Lord descends to the earth and stands on Mount Olive. Okay, and that begins the Armageddon war to destroy the Antichrist. At the rapture, Christ comes where? In the air. We meet him in the clouds. Are you following me, church? Amen. Soon coming, Christ comes down on earth to establish his kingdom. It's different. So at the rapture, Christ will not come on earth. He'll be where? In the clouds. And we meet him in the air. Are you following the church?
Yes.
Are you still following him?
Yes.
Some are sleeping. Are you sleeping? Are you sleeping?
No.
Hey, what's happening here? Hallelujah.
Amen.
So what kind of Christ is Christ descending on Mount Olive and destroying Antichrist and the world powers to establish his kingdom? The rapture, we meet him in the air. And the fourth one of the view. The doctrine of the rapture was not taught in the Old Testament. That is why Paul called it what? A mystery. It's a mystery.
A mystery.
Amen. Now take the 1 Corinthians, please. 1 Corinthians 15, 51, 52, please. Hold it for me. 1 Corinthians 15, 51, 52.
Behold, I tell you a mystery.
Behold, I tell you what? A mystery, a hidden secret revealed to me. Yeah.
We shall not all sleep.
We all will not die.
But we shall all be changed.
We all will change.
In a moment,
in a twinkling of an eye.
At the last trumpet. For the trumpet will sound.
And the dead will be raised.
Incorruptible.
Say we this and what? Those who are alive shall be changed. We shall be changed. Yeah.
For this corruptible incorruption.
Yeah.
And this mortal must put on
immortality. Just end it. So we shall be changed. This is very important to know that the rapture of the church, you know, the rapture was a mystery hidden in the Old Testament. God revealed it to Paul. We shall not all die. At the moment, at the twinkle of an eye, we shall be what? Changed. Hallelujah. Now, the word twinkle of the eye means what? As you close and open your blink your eye and look at me, in a split second, things have changed in the world. Hallelujah. Say
rapture
with the worst disaster in human history. Imagine my brother there, please. You are flying your plane, you vanish. The passengers are crossed somewhere. You are not born again. Imagine you are in a Boeing 737 flying to Asia, the pilot vanished. What happened to the plane and the passengers?
Crash.
Imagine you are driving to work and you have to pay with your car, you vanish. Your car crash. How many car crashes will be on that day? How many job vacancies will be on that day? All over the world. The world will collapse. And the Antichrist says, I can solve this crisis. Have the answer. Okay, companies will close because no more applicants. Believers are gone. Okay, please, the last one this morning. Amen. The rapture of the church is a glorious event we should all be longing for. We will finally be free from this sinful world and the troubles of the fallen man. Now, before I close, please, you need to differentiate. There are three theories about the rapture. How many theories? Three. Number one, there is pre-tribulation theory. It's a pre-tribulation. It's a pre-tribulation. It means rapture occurred before what? The great tribulation. We call it what? Pre-tribulation theory. That's what I believe. Number two, there is mid-tribulation theory. Mid means rapture will take place at the middle of the tribulation, after the first 3.5 years, and the rapture before the great tribulation. The third theory is the post-tribulation theory. Rapture takes place after tribulation. These are different beliefs out there.
Yeah.
Okay? But we believe in what? Pre-tribulation theory. Why? 1 Thessalonians 5, verse 8 to 10. 1 Thessalonians 5, verse 8 to 10 says what? We are not called unto wrath. Say, I'm not called.
I'm not called
unto wrath.
Unto wrath.
Before the judgment, God picks us out.
Amen.
Amen. Now, to end, can we stand up, please? Let's end this morning with this passage. Turn to Luke, please. Turn to Luke 17.